for your defense.
Just me. I don't know what else you want.
This is the dumbest case I've taken. It'll be over within the hour.
Oh, you have no idea.
Ladies, gentlemen, in all other configurations of being, we're about to take a journey back to the horrifying year of 1992. Yes, doesn't this seem like an extremely interesting play that you are all excited to watch? No? Well, 1992 happened to be the same year as the shocking court case Old Woman versus Bones. Bum, bum, bum! Twists, turns, friends become rivals, rivals become enemies, enemies become lovers. You are now about to enter the courtroom of Judge Senior Justice. The people are real, the cases are real, and the rulings are final. This is Jury's Out.
Mom, what are you doing here?
All rise for Judge Senior Justice.
Order! Order! Yes, I would like to order a large number four, an extra mini sauce. Yes, and could you?
Oh, crap! Order!
Your Honor, this is a clear conflict of interest concern that the defendant is speaking with a member of the jury, one of whom is my own mother.
Yes, well, you must understand that the senior court takes cases such as this very seriously, especially when involving such heinous crimes, such as,
Your Honor,
so
you're looking for?
Ah, yes, thank you, I lost that. Let's see here. The defendant, Joe Bones.
Whoa, 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 folks. All right, I think I can give a bit more of an honest description of what's going on. So there was I, making my way out down Crimes Alley, when all of a sudden I just see this woman there, standing there, staring at me. But I wasn't doing her no harm.
He was seen in the back alley, suspiciously approaching the victim with seemingly murderous intent.
So there was I, minding my own business, when all of a sudden she pulls out a magnet, an honest to God magnet. I'm telling you, I was fearing for my life.
Cornering the victim, the defendant proceeded to
tremble in fear. She jumped me. And so, in defense of my own life, I
before they finally
shot
the victim in the chest.
Bang!
Seven times.
Seven? Oh yeah, seven times.
Bang,
bang, bang, bang, bang, bang, bang, bang. Like I said, no biggie. Victimless crime. Y'all don't think I really did it, does yous?
No.
Hey, yo, my man, and because I'm so innocent, I packed the courtroom. That means that every juror in this room is 100% Joe proof. And the best part of it all, they were all at the scene of the crime.
Did literally anyone just...
Shut up. This is the best part of the case. Ladies and gentlemen, the court is now in session. I've always wanted to say that. This is a big deal for me. The prosecution may now, you can do your thing.
Thank you, Your Honor. So, Mr. Bones, would you agree it was a hot Saturday night when you interacted with this woman?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Would you also agree that you approached this woman?
That old hag came at me first.
So you do admit that you approached her. Would you also agree that you, Mr. Bones, proceeded to attack this defenseless woman?
Like I said before, she jumped me.
And where's your evidence, Mr. Bones?
Right here. I'd like to call my first witness to the stand. Senile old woman.
Can we please use legal names in the courtroom?
Now listen here, you little whippersnapper. My name has been in the old woman family for hundreds of generations. I will not have my name slandered in the house of justice such as this. Thank you for having me. It's been so long since I've been out of the house. You see, my daughter keeps me locked in my room. And usually she's pretty tight on these things, but
relevance.
I'm getting it! Kids these days have no respect for storytelling. So, one night, I escaped. So there I was, valiantly grappling down from the 10-story window of my apartment. With a great leap, I pushed off, performing what experts would call Olympic-level acrobatics. And gracefully landing on the street below, it was very excellent. And for part two of my master plan, pizza. More specifically, my favorite pizza in the whole city, Bob's Pizza.
Hey, yo!
And Oh yes, so I head into the crowd's alley, the quickest way to get to Bob's. I'm about to walk through the door when my good old pal Bob informed me that his head chef is unavailable to work. Whatever that means. My plan was thwarted, so I started back home. Oh yes, I heard a lady in distress back in Crime's Alley. I dashed to the scene of the crime, but when I got there, all I saw was BOOM! And he was aiming a. Oh yes, he was beating this lady with a baseball bat. Oh yes, he was beating this lady with a bat, and this was no. Oh, it wasn't bad at all. It was a comic and large spoon. Oh no. No, it wasn't a spoon at all. It was.
I'm not okay enough for this. Just pick one. Pick one thing.
Oh yes. Joe has gone and shot him with an honest to God magnum.
Big.
Seven times.
Big.
Shot it all over. But I know Joe Bones, and he's too good at. Guy to bone someone like that.
See, case closed. Up and down, cut up and dry. At the store, court of drawers.
Oh, I think we need to address some issues with that testimony. To start off, I find it odd that no one has mentioned that a jury member is also a witness, which is not standard procedure.
Says who?
Says Cornell University. Rule 606, jurors' competency as a witness, Section A, at the trial. A juror may not be called to testify as a witness before the other jurors at the trial. If a juror is called to testify, the court must give a party an opportunity to object outside the jury's presence.
I didn't understand that.
Of course you didn't. However, even disregarding the absolute abuse of the court system, a senile old woman is not fit to be a juror, considering she cannot comfortably recall recent events. Therefore, it's in the best interest of my client.
Well, sorry to say, but I still got more victims to burn through. And I'm really gonna love this next one. I'd like to call my next witness to the stand. Your mother. So, babes.
It's
in. Well, tomato, babe. So, honey, where were you at the scene of the crime?
Connor, I'm just going to pass it back. That is my mom.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, but just making sure. I can take it from here, so. It was a hot, hot Saturday night, and I was heading out to a hot, hot day when I was going there. You flirts. Hold up. You were with Joe on Saturday? I called you about movie night, and you said you were filing your taxes.
Miss Morales, what is your relationship with Joe?
By the night of the crime, Joe and I had been dating for about 2 weeks. And to celebrate our 2-month anniversary, to celebrate our union, we decided to go on a classic romantic date where we kill people and rob the small places.
Hey, Bob, it's your
man, Robbie. Hey, Mary, can we come over here for a second, sweetie?
I need you.
Wait, so I get to see more stuff? Wow, it was so good to be wanted. I thought it was going to happen.
We have to work fast. So I warned the owner I killed head chef as revenge. He didn't give us all the money to register right now. When he revealed that there wasn't actually any money to register, we killed his head chef as revenge.
Don't shoot my brain. I need it for addressing court cases in walk over the top dramatic fashion.
Okay.
Get back in from the hole! Stop the name of the law!
Anyways, we were so close to freedom that Joe shot the old woman in the tree.
Fake!
bones.
Well, there's his charming smile, his roguish personality, and they don't call him Joe Bones for nothing.
I'm going to die.
I see no further evidence is needed for Mr. Joe here. It was clearly self-defense, as his prosecution smiled.
It's Angie.
As Angie stated, I see that no further evidence is needed. Mr. Bones is clearly innocent.
Whoa! We've still got 15 minutes left in the play.
Yeah, I haven't even gotten to speak yet. This cannot be happening.
It can and it is, little man.
By the way, is anyone here hungry? Maybe for a slice of Italian goodness?
Objection!
Relevance! I like how this young man talks.
Hi, my name is Bob Pizzazz, spelled P-I-Z-Z-A-S. And I run a local pizza joint, Bob's Pizza. It's great to be here. A real treat, a real treat. I've been serving up greasy slices ever since my father, Bob Pizzazz, founded the restaurant in 1972. Over 20 years of mouth-watering pies, no matter the occasion. The crunchy, crispy, extra stuffed crust loaded with toppings that will crush your cravings with mind-melting flavor. Flavor. Again, that's Bob Pizza. If you call this number here in the next 15 minutes, you'll receive nothing.
Respect. Is this how all your pizzas go?
What could you possibly mean?
Well, Your Honor, never in all my years have I encountered a trial quite so... How do I put this? Inconceivably asinine and impossible as the one that you are holding right now. I ask you, how many cases have you actually presided over?
And you don't talk to the judge that way, I know that much. And now the judge says that we all settle down, let the funny pizza man say his piece.
Well, I guess I'll say my piece. All right. So, you know the drill. There I was, laundering money, fraudulently filing my taxes, all things a good business owner does. But I hear a crash go boom come through my parlor. I came outside my office to see two guys in ski masks busting through my door. One of the guys there.
It's Angie.
Yeah, Angie. I'm my head chef, Jimmy John, dealing against the counter with them. You dicks. They pull the trigger if you don't give the money in the register right now.
It's not my fortune to get it anymore.
But as a wise businessman with sound judgment,
I lied. Told them there was no money in the register. Honestly, didn't think they'd believe me because of my long history of public scams and cops. But they did. And they shot Jimmy on the spot.
Wait a second. To be honest, I don't know how you got me.
I was about to check on Jimmy when I realized two things. It was closing time, and I don't care about my minimum wage employees. I was about to punch out when this senile looking old woman comes up asking if we have any pizza. I told them, no, here at Bob's Pizza, 123 Pizza Street, recognized Crime Alley, which you can reach at this number. We're fresh up. Never before had I seen such a sad-looking fellow. She left and I was walking up when I hear a loud gunshot and scream comes out. When I got out there, I saw the same lady looking at the two guys who killed my Jimmy. And there was this lady dying on the ground, gushing blood like our pizza gushes fresh tomato sauce. My eyes finally settled on the guys. The same guys who killed my Jimmy just minutes ago. I couldn't believe what he was holding. He had, I kid you not, an honest to God who...
I'm not paying
you for that. Slice of pizza! Again, that's Bob's Pizza. Mind you, located at... Well, you get it. I thought what a dedicated customer. That's enough! Get off me! Cut out, stupid pizza time music! What is this? What are you doing? Right now, I said this to be an honorable court of law, and the moment I stepped into this chamber, I knew something was amiss. Not a single member of this jury agreed with that. Oh well, the president had to see.
courtroom safe. Lying appears at every possible juncture, and still, every single one of you has been threatened or silenced into conforming by the greasiest slimeball of a man I've ever had the utmost displeasure of being in a room with. You, Bone!
I mean, I do occasionally.
And I'm aware with my mother, and you, sir, are guilty. Guilty far beyond the shadow of a reasonable doubt. You'll get the highest degree and of the greatest magnitude. But what shocks me the most is that none of the nonsensical shenanigans or tomfoolery that have occurred within the past 15 minutes matter, because this is not a real courtroom, because you are not a real judge.
Miss Morales, you are completely right. I'm a fraud.
Yes, I... Wait, really?
So there I was,
at the hottest costume party of 1982.
I was dressed as a judge.
I was young and stupid, and I regret my mistakes. I took to the streets, terrifying innocent youths, when suddenly I really had to use the bathroom. At least I went to have one. But by my lucky stars, I stumbled upon this very courthouse, and there just so happened to be a bathroom inside. I'd almost reached the bathroom when a bailiff pulled me aside and asked,
"Where have you been? The case started 30 minutes ago."
I tried to tell him that it was just a costume, but then he just said,
"Don't worry, I'll show you how this works."
But before I had the time to ask my dad, then he just threw me behind this big thing. Gave me some papers, and I drew a couple little sailboats here and there. And then everybody stopped and stared at me. I didn't know what to do. Presiding over cases and walking from room to room for the past 10 years. And you figure that out after 15 minutes. You, Miss Morales, are the greatest attorney that I have ever met.
Yeah, I am pretty great, aren't I?
I'll be honest, I'm a pretty dumb guy. But of all the confusing things I've dealt with while I've been trapped here, the most confusing has been why my bailiff foe is the witness in this case.
All right, what is it this time? Let me guess, you saw the crime in a dream, or wait, no. You're the president here to grant him a presidential pardon. Oh yes, that must be it. I saw it coming from a mile away.
No, it's much simpler than that. I'm him from the future.
No!
Wait, him?
Me?
Yes. I, Bo Jones, am from the future, and I brought you all here to wrong a right.
Wait. You were the bailiff this whole time. I didn't even know that I'm the narrator. You've been had.
Yes, you had. Have. You have been had. You have been had. Have. Evil plan time. You see? Time for the future, where Joe Bones, as you know, is captured, prosecuted, and receives a life sentence. Unfortunately for you, I studied quantum physics and built a time machine during my sentence. It's kind of weird that they had time machine parts just laying around, but lazy writing by the directors, I guess. At any rate, I can go wherever I wanted, but to my dismay, as my life grew dull, I only wanted one thing, to get my youth spent in prison back. You see, in my timeline, the crime had no witnesses. So I went back in time and impacted each and every one of your lives, so you'd end up here today. And so that your Joe Bones can threaten you into lying to the path out of prison.
What? That's so mean and illegal. I would never do anything illegal.
Why, boy, the grown-ups are talking. So if any of you remember any of those flashback montages, we literally just did those. You, old woman. You don't remember me as that guy who loaded you to go towards that screen? And you, my darling, and the love of my life, I kept every letter you sent to me while I was locked away.
Oh, that's so sweet. And also kind of creepy. I may be getting this wrong, but aren't you like 75 or
10? First of all, Al, I'm only 95. And secondly, you don't remember me as that cop who scared you from Ron's alley? And you! You truly old fool, you were never my friend. I just used your incompetence to help me win this case. So thanks for taking all my stupid advice.
Oh yeah. Well, guess what? I never liked you either. So yeah.
I can't believe you fell for it, especially you, my sweet, sweet Bobby.
Wait, my father! What did you do to my dad?
Oh, Bobby, I am your father.
No!
court that is not completely incompetent. You were at the original court case and you swept the floor with me. But now, who has the upper hand? And I ask the jury if all the prior evidence does not convince you that he and I are not innocent, then just remember I can go back in time and just baby you 7 times with my honest to God night note. Bang, 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 bang. Thank you for your time.
Look, hey man, like everyone's freaking out or something since the disco ball is a god.
What? Who on earth was my mother's precious disco ball? It was my mother's! Like, she'll never forgive me. We have to hide this, Texas. This is meant for Reginald.
Stay alive. why a man who looks like you is at a luxurious disco club like this?
I work here, man.
Ah, so you are resentful that your boss wants revenge for your wages, so you steal the disco ball.
Well, yes. Well, I'd love to do something like that. I'm currently on parole.
Pray tell us, what did you do?
Well, after being bit by the alligator that I intended to throw through the Wendy's driver's window, I was then brought to the hospital to get stitches. Now, if that wasn't enough, I think I went to the hospital, but they wouldn't let me leave.
I'm so pleased, sir. What?
No, man. I'm not done yet. You see, I was trying to leave the hospital, but they wouldn't let me. So naturally, man, I stole an ambulance to drive myself home. Turns out those things have trackers. So it wasn't a long drive.
I think we're getting off topic a bit. Please remind us how this connects to the ball.
Well, I went to jail after the whole, let's say, incident, so I can steal the disco ball. Because now I'm on parole. And I don't want to go back!
You didn't put that on your resume.
I think you didn't go. Out the door. You!
Give me actually, we're a trio. Speak to all of us, talk to all of us.
Word.
I have a given, just come here.
Why are there three of you? The pew, I told you to bring in one at a time. How can I be expected to work in conditions like this?
They insisted so.
Very well. And what do you three answer that question?
Let me formally introduce myself. I'm Carlisle, head of the National Curling Team.
And I, the best player on the team, am Seamus. Call me Eduardo for short, or Ed for shorter.
I'm the reason we're all here tonight. My name's Jarvis.
Excellent. Getting to the point. Please tell me what brings you three to this fine disco club on this fine Tuesday afternoon.
You know, football players do ballet to move their form.
Mm-hmm, for sure. I was quite the quarterback ballerina in my day, after my many years being a ballerina receiver, of course. Let me tell you, the ladies in ballet class loved it. Could pace like nobody's business.
Thank you for that unnecessary and scarring tidbit, businessman. Back to you.
So, Charmaine comes to practice one day and is all freaking hyped up about the ballet thing.
But I'm like, Charmaine, what are you talking about? Everyone knows that ballet is out, but disco is in.
And I was like, you are so right. We have to go to a disco club to get better at curling.
So, here we are, doing the disco, and catch this.
I don't even know what we're doing here. the other room? That thing's great. Real sparkly.
Yes, it was, but someone stole it.
It is? It's gone? You guys should get someone to look into that.
Is it me, sir? I think so, Chuck. Okay, let's stop from the beginning. Why are you here tonight?
Well, I was on my way to Woodstock 79, but the people didn't really like me, so they just left me. By the way, I need an oyster, like the steak, and the cracker, and the thing in the ocean. You feel me, brother?
No, not really. So you were hitchhiking and stopped here?
Pretty much.
Do you have any idea who could have stolen the disco ball?
Is that what we're doing here? Honestly, man, it could have been me. Like, maybe not, but quite possibly.
Yes! So you confess?
You're stealing the disco ball? Nah, man. I don't steal. Peace, brother. Can't mix Country Joe and the fish.
Wait. Peace, brother.
Peace, brother. You know what you guys should do? You should look into that funny guy there with the chest hair.
Could it really be? Like you? You were dressed to disco. Reginald, think of all this that we've been through. Do you really think I could have done something like this to you?
He has been coming in quite often.
It's true. We were beginning to think he was getting suspicious when he slept was the business.
And it has been suspicious that he's wearing the same thing every time he's come in.
Up you. I don't want to think it was you, but all the signs point to my little up you. Be honest, up you. Bang, it was me. But how could you do it? You're supposed to be in this together. I am not the man of crime, but this is a much more serious matter. You see, I am the descendant of the creator of the disco ball, the real creator. My grandfather worked his behind off to create the disco ball, and stupid Louis Bernard Disco stole his idea to all the credit. So now, I am traveling the world, stealing every last disco ball, and this is my very last one. But how did you do it? Such an intricate, advanced, intelligent crime. Through the bathroom window. You, I will not stand for this. We are supposed to solve crime, not commit it.
And what about my mother's precious disco ball? I want to return at once.
Duck, you will return that disco ball this instant. As for the others, you'll be returning every single one to its rightful owner when we travel the world together next spring.
But Reginald...
Enough, Duck, you! Get that disco ball this instant!
You're going to get slap on the wrist.
Very well. Pleasure doing business with you. The check will be sent in the mail.
Come on, Lapio.
Thank you. seen another human in 6 months. And I just used the last of my meds yesterday, so hallucinations might start up again.
If someone could please remove the guy from behind my vehicle, I have an appointment at 11:30. I paid a lot of money for it, so if you could please carry him out or something. I checked, he was bleeding. Thank you, and I'm sorry for your loss.
God damn it, I need my line on!
I would like to thank the person who revealed the punchline in the first line. It was something I wrote down earlier when I got this gig, and I didn't want to disrespect the family and correct it, so thank you. This is not a drill. Please remove the dead man. I'm very concerned for his friends and family.
Wait, God, think about it!
I'm sorry, Ben.
pay your partner?
And because you don't pay your partner, we're taking his mustache. We got the mustache! Huzzah!
But you're not real. None of this is real. Is that what you still think?
I mean, yeah.
Let me show you one more memory. Then you can decide if any of this was real, or just another one of your hallucinations.
And again, yes, you're my best friend of all time. I'm gonna break this thing down just for you. Feel a little rap words, and just take over the mic.
by yourself.
Can you breathe?
Can you feel it?
Is it too much?
Were you too weak?
You abandoned them.
Or did they abandon you?
It's your mind.
Your thoughts.
Just you.
Your fear.
Your guilt. Your doubts.
Your feelings.
Your thoughts.
Your pain.
Just you.
The good and the bad. Although most of it is bad. You deserved all of it.
The loneliness.
Pain.
The failure.
You deserved it. All of it.
Where am I? Who are you? What's happening?
Questions, questions. So many questions.
Think. Listen.
Reach out.
You will know.
What the hell does that mean? Can you not speak normally and just answer me?
Reach out.
You will lay down.
Resting in a bed.
Beeps of the monitor. The cries of your mother.
The voice of your father.
Listen to their words.
What a friendship.
What a
power, one of pain,
heroism, love,
art,
tragedy,
anything. Except what happened. I don't want to think about it. I don't want to remember. I don't want to feel that pain again.
What about the pain of others? Your occurrence is enough.
The words of your parents.
And they would really come to find you.
The fear and guilt they felt.
How they failed you.
Their only child.
Listen to their words.
Never my time.
Now, try to let it go. All
keeping you trapped.
You eat yourself.
It's too much. I can't.
There's no other way. If you want to leave.
Free yourself.
Leave the doubt behind.
Free yourself.
Let the sadness go.
Free yourself.
The skill consume you.
Free yourself.
You're not as alone as you feel.
Free yourself.
You have control over your thoughts.
Free yourself.
That anger will subside and make her but that's living.
Free yourself.
You always have us lingering in the back. But there is so much more.
Free yourself.
I don't know how.
Focus on your breathing. In and out. Don't think of anything else.
It hurts. I hate it.
I know. But pain is part of living. You'll be alright. Focus. You're in control. Things can get better.
How?
By trying. Having hope.
What if I don't? What if I want it to be all over for good?
Then it's your choice. I can't stop you. No one here can stop you. But you don't want it to be all over for good. Remember the joys of life? The time you spent all night with your friends at the sleepover playing video games? The day you helped your mother make drinks in the kitchen? The time you wrote a song using a guitar your friends got you for your 12th birthday? You want to go back to these happy moments. You want your life to be like that again. That happiness doesn't have to end. You're in control of your life. You can find those joys again.
Is that even possible? I ruined everything in my life.
No, you didn't. You can get out. Have some hope that things can get better with the help of those who care. Almost time for your filming.
Go where?
Wherever you want. You can return to the waking world? To your family? You can make your life better. All you have to do is try. There are so many people who want to help you, who want you in their life. You just have to let them in. Those who truly care will love you regardless of any struggles you're facing. You define you. But you can move on from here, like you've been asking, to go somewhere else, whether it be an afterlife or simply ceasing to be.
I want to try again. I want to go home.
I'll be with you when you do. All you need to do now is wake up.
Remember they have other people to help.
There's never a hopeless situation.
only helplessness surrounding the situation.
And if you can't find anyone else to talk to, please call the National Suicide Hotline number at 988. Thank you.
Trust me, the cute couple thing wears off really quick.
Really, it does. Julia,
nice to meet you. Lady Capulet, how do you do?
The mighty Lord Capulet at your service.
Friar Lawrence, pleasure to meet you.
My name is Benvolio!
Then somebody better go get Romeo before the tomb scene
or so help me God, you will all feel my wrath.
Hey, Tibble! Killer Shane's my man.
Killer? Oh, no, I've been caught. He's so drunk and I'm probably going to notice.
Chest bump. Sorry. You gotta be wearing the bump, bro. See you later, Tyrone.
Hold up. Yeah, no clue.
Can we take a break? You're so heavy.
You're telling me! You're just walking and pretending now. I'm doing all the work! At least I was helpful.
Why don't you carry him then?
No way, I already have my turn. Enough! I say we just leave him here and walk away. No! Are you kidding? We can't just leave him here? People have seen us, but we'll be prime suspects. They haven't seen anything. They don't have any evidence. They don't know it was us.
I didn't tell them what happened. Don't worry, guys. We all saw it. That's why we're trying to hide the body, obviously. And you think I am the dump? Ow!
What was that for?
You idiot, you're gonna get us all arrested. We don't want anybody to know.
Oh!
Okay, now wait to see if find smart stash buddy or we'll be gone for a while.
Care to hear what I think?
Sure, nobody else seems to be.
Not this time. The next time, check to see if someone's okay before you go and hide their body.
We thought you were dead.
You weren't moving. There you are. Thank God. They're running the tomb scene and we need you.
Okay, I'll finish this conversation later. Don't kill anybody in the meantime.
No promises.
Romeo and Tibble!
Just suck it up and do the stupid scene already!
All my own self-pity.
Why did you not run by his feet?
Well, I found him in the back stairwell and I told him we had to run the tomb scene and he just said no and stomped his foot and I said yes and I told him we had to run the tomb scene before tonight because the death scene's always a bit shaky and he said you can't make me! So I grabbed his foot and dragged him here.
That makes perfect sense.
Romeo, listen to me. Nothing happened between me and Friar Lawrence.
How can you say that? I saw you.
I tripped on his foot in the dark and we both fell.
It's true. You know I would never do something like that to you. You're my best friend, dude.
So nothing happened? Really?
Yes, really. I only have eyes for you, babe. I love you.
I'm sorry I did that. I'll never do it again. I love you too.
Help, Romeo!
Now that that touching scene is over, let's bring up the fact that the Capulets tried to cover up my murder. Well, yeah. They thought it was, tried to hide my body.
And we are so sorry. We didn't want to go to jail. I don't look good, Lawrence, and it would mess up my nails. We figured we'd provide a peaceful place to bury you after the show.
Really?
We did. But you're okay now, so yay.
Find us somewhere real nice.
What he said.
You were gonna find a place to bury me?
Essentially.
Alright, I guess it was an accident, but next time, check to see if someone's okay before you go and bury them.
Yes, okay. Deal!
Attention, everybody! I wanted you all to know that Maria and I are getting married. And you're
So that's where that ladder went. I knew I left it by that platform. Somebody get him sobered up before tonight. The rest of you, all of those mistakes need to be fixed by 8 p.m. sharp. I am absolutely disgusted at how unprepared you all are.
Not by a long shot. But I feel that all the mistakes made it even more special.
But the script and all of those rehearsals and notes and... Oh, what the heck. I don't get paid enough to care anyway. Give me that. All this drama, and it's only the Saturday show. God help us all.
Nasty infection. Duran, it's been him down in the dumpster and storage, Michael died and OJ, well, you know how OJ is.
Oh, not the update I was expecting.
Enough about the boys, how was Southern France?
Well, I didn't really get to see it. Taking the baguette burglars really took up the ideal sightseeing time, but the weather was nice.
That's good. I'll need a report by Tuesday. Mr. Head gave me a file for you that I guess I misplaced. He's been trying to crack a case since you left, but no luck. Oh well, you can go right inside. I'm sure he'll fill you in.
Hey?
Do you want me to get you some coffee?
No, I'll just
go in. Hello.
Oh, Spy 1, you're here. I was just telling Spy 2 here about the old new job.
Really? I thought that was confidential.
Okay, Mr. Head. The stories are great, but now my partner's here.
I'm sorry. What?
Oh, Spy 1, if you had been here on time, Mason would have told you all about him. But all's well, this is Spy 2, fresh out of spy school, top of his class. I think he'll make a great addition to the organization.
Mr. Head, I really don't think I need a partner. I mean, I've been taking names and kicking ass since 07.
If you'd like me to step outside, you can see I'll give you coffee over here.
Spy 2, here's the file. Spy 1, play nice.
Who are we dealing with?
Let's just say you've dealt with him before.
That's not a lot to go on.
You solved bigger cases with a lot less. Tally-ho!
Well, I guess we got a bad guy to catch. Partners?
Thank you for tuning into this breaking news. We will see you at 11.
complicated.
Complicated? How?
I didn't go to Spies. I went to a community college. But when I was there, it was a class called Intro to the Field. I was an agricultural science major, so I thought it was about farming. It wasn't.
Why didn't you just drop the class?
Well, I was sick for the first 3 weeks. I got the flu, which turned into pneumonia. And then my cousin came over to help me out. He's not the chillest guy on the planet. I broke my tailbone when he was teaching me his best party trick, skateboarding while playing Careless Whisper on the saxophone. Needless to say, I missed the dropout deadline. But I wasn't about to let $400 go to waste.
What does any of that have to do with you not going to spy school?
Class wound up being an intro to spying, you know. Intro, field. It's not funny.
I'm sorry, it's not. So how did you end up here?
Well, I know Mr. Head.
How?
Same every year at Christmas.
Okay, now I'm confused.
1 year I got him this mug and said, "Oh, best grandma."
You're his. He mentioned he had a family butter.
You know, all my life I thought Mr. Head was just my retired old gramps with a really unfortunate last name. Turns out he was funding that spy course, and he found I enrolled to send me a letter explaining everything. He taught me everything he knew about spying, took me right under his wing. Turns out the information was a bit outdated and useless, but he made me keep everything a secret to hide his nepotism.
I'm calling Mr. Head.
No! If you tell me no, I'll tell him you cheated on your final exam in spy school.
Joke's on you! I forged my diploma!
How are you here? I saw your file. You graduated in 05.
I lied.
Mr. Head's the head of a spy organization. Do you think he has ways of finding out?
I don't know how he hasn't found out yet, but weren't we just talking about how you didn't go to spy school either? How's this any different?
I'm at least trained. How are you at all qualified?
I've watched a lot of spy movies, and I have a lot of help from the inside. I mean, does it look like I could forge a diploma?
I think you could if you tried hard enough. Well, I guess that makes us even. I know something about you, you know something about me.
Well, that doesn't exactly help us, as we have no clues.
I think it helps.
How?
We're partners?
Let me know if you find anything.
Hey. What I found.
Nice job, Spec, too. I know who this is. I know where we need to go. Come on.
And that's why you're going to be my therapist. It's also why I quit a big one. Plus your soul. Plus your soul. Didn't wear y'all on Wednesday. Now that you've heard my brilliant plan, any questions, any critiques?
Any questions? Any critiques? Oh, bad guy, I have so many. First, my critique. Kidnapping the second most powerful person in the spy organization? Rookie move. Mr. Head has had the spies on your trails for weeks. Second, my question. What happened to the Queen of England? I had tea with her last Wednesday, and might I add, she was wearing the classiest yellow dress and hat combo.
Queen? A queen? Did I say queen? Yes, we're critiques. Hank and I know what we're doing. Maybe leading the spies was our plan all along. Maybe I've been skimming to the left.
I get
that! I found you at last.
Well, it took you a long time. I've been leading out to the left and right. The footprints, the pomegranates, my house key.
What are you talking about? We only found the notebook.
What notebook? Oh, that's where that went. Well, it doesn't matter.
Old friend.
Old friend! Who is this guy?
Who's this guy?
I'm her partner.
It's not what it looks like.
Oh, I think it is. I spent the past 8 months killing people just to see you. Did you go and do this?
It's really, really not what it seems.
I can tell my services are appreciated, so I'm leaving. Hench, let's go.
You always leave.
Hang on a second. These guys are just murderers, and you're gonna let them go? Fine. Everything myself. Bad guys, sit down. But there's a person there. Why can't I let her go?
I'm calling Mr. Head. I'll see you two at the office and you two in jail.
Okay, now, Spy One, please explain.
Go on.
No one wants to hear my version of the story.
My parents grew up close. We grew up together, side by side, best of friends. Our favorite pastime was watching spy movies. We reenacted the scenes and everything. So, when we were old enough, we dreamed to become spies and work together. So, we both applied to spy school.
You said you never went to spy school. We just had a whole conversation about it.
That guy got in, and I didn't. I was never jealous. He deserved everything he had, but it was hard seeing him live our dream without me. That guy felt bad for me, so he taught me everything he learned in spy school. It wasn't the same as being there, but it was nice.
You said you learned everything from the movies.
Ha! Is that what you told him?
Yeah, I lied. It's all bad. Anyways, that guy graduated from spy school, got a job at the spy organization, helped me pick a diploma, and recommended me to Mr. Head.
We worked as partners for years. The longer we were there, the more Spy One excelled. Mr. Head started favoring her, and gave her a raise. It was my turn to be jealous. I couldn't stand being second place to Spy One when she shouldn't have even been there in the first place. My jealousy got the better of me, so on a cold Tuesday night, I packed my things and took a three-week-long trip to Russia. And that's where I kidnapped my darling nurse.
You didn't even leave a note.
Quite frankly, my dear, I thought you were too busy eating cookies and solving cases when Mr. Head didn't even care.
Of course I cared. You were my best friend.
Then you should have acted like it.
I'm sorry for not helping you the way you would help me. I guess I was just caught up in the excitement of finally being a real spy. I didn't know how much it affected you.
We canceled our annual viewing of Mission Impossible to go on a solo mission. You crossed the line. That is not something I can do.
You're right. Spy 2, we came here because we have a job to do. Bad guy, we came here to arrest you because you've killed people. Can't even believe I apologized.
I know that's what you came here to do, and I know you're upset with Bad Guy. But if you can give me 2 minutes with him, I can try to fix things. I know you're upset, but you set this whole thing up just to see Spy One again. What did you think was going to happen? 2 murders and a kidnapping? The best you were going to get was an apology. Why didn't you take it? You thought that was an apology? I don't know how things are done here in America, but in Russia, when somebody says, I'm sorry, it's usually an apology.
Honestly, Hench, I'm scared. I didn't think this far ahead. Killing people? No problem. Having an honest conversation with my ex-best friend who I left in the middle of the night without a note? Terrifying. This was bad
idea.
Let's just do it.
Absolutely not. You're going to turn around and apologize like your life depends on it. Because it does. And if you can't do it for yourself, do it for me. I cannot last in prison.
Oh, my one, please don't throw our pretty butts in jail. That's what we have to handle. Look at it. I'm sorry I was such a bad friend. I'm sorry I left in the first place. I should have recognized we're going in different directions. Your name's Spy One, my name's Bad Guy. What did I think was going to happen?
Bad Guy, you should have just talked to me.
I was embarrassed. I didn't want you to know how jealous I was.
Bad Guy, communication is key. If you had brought it up, I would have explained it the best I could, or even stopped taking the jobs. I couldn't tell you about the missions because of the safety rules in the spy organization. Once you're assigned a case, you've got to keep a tight lip. The more people who know about the job, the more danger they're in. I never wanted to do that to you. And the only reason Mr. Head gave me those assignments was because you can't swim. Remember Seahorse Rodeo?
Oh, Seahorse Rodeo.
Marine Mayhem?
Yeah, I got it.
Bad Guy. and Tenchman back to the headquarters and see if we can get your old job back. I'm still in the
Hang on a second. Spyware, is that really the best idea? I mean, it's great that you two aren't getting along and making up or whatever, but they killed people. You're just gonna, you know, bring it back to the headquarters? They killed people.
I'm sorry, but have you not been hearing what I've been hearing? Because I've been hearing a heartfelt reunion that must be protected. How often do you get a story like this that doesn't end in short film? Besides, we're only murderers by law, not by heart.
That literally doesn't make any sense.
Spy 2, if you don't help me get their jobs back, I'm gonna tell Mr. Head about.
Fine.
They killed people, as your top spy, and dare I say, friend, I beg of you to allow bad guy come back to the job.
Although I don't condone murder, I'm willing to forgive and forget. Welcome to the team, back.
Does that mean a man?
It does. Now, I know it's a little early to ask for favors, but I'm feeling generous, so I'll allow it. Does that mean you two would like to work together again?
Can it be the four of us?
Absolutely.